Hello, this is Michael Slapsky here for a nice tutorial on getting some spray paint looks with Trapcode Particular. This was sparked by a friend of mine asking, can you make spray paint with Particular? The answer is yes, you can. There's a bunch of different ways you can do it. Here's just one, and a bunch of different ways you can use it. Enjoy. Like every great idea in a cartoon, we're gonna start this with a light bulb. Let's get a light in here. I've done it earlier, so it's already, I guess I'm gonna pick a nice hot pink color. That's gonna be our paint color. And really narrow cone angle, because we're going to be using this cone angle to point where the particles are going. And we're going to call it emitter one, because we're going to use it as an emitter. That's really all we need to do. Now we want to make sure it's pointing straight down. First of all, let's get this at zero on Z. And I'm going to hit A for a point of interest. So you can see we move this point of interest around. It's pointing the light different places. Now you could just put this point of interest really far down. That way, whenever you move this, it's basically pointing down, but you know, it'll still be a little bit of an angle, which, I mean, it'll be fine for what we are doing. But if you want to be like really specific about it, you can alt click on the point of interest, point it with the expression to the position, and then just add, let's say zero on the X, then I don't know, maybe 900 on the Y and nothing on the Z. So whatever this position is going to be, the point of interest is gonna be the exact same, just pointing down from it. So there we go. Now, the next thing we need to do is we want this light to animate because it's going to be the shape that our spray paint is going to be in. This is our emitter spitting out all our particles. We're going to use something called motion sketch for this. Motion sketch won't work on 3D layers, so I'm going to make a null just temporarily here. And we'll hit window motion sketch. And if you're not familiar with motion sketch, it's basically you just draw with your tablet or mouse and it'll animate something for you. So with my null selected, I'm going to hit start capture. Nothing happens until I click, and then it will keep animating as long as I've clicked down. So I need to draw whatever we're drawing all in one fell swoop. So either write in cursive or deal with the fact that you're gonna have to be messing with keyframes later to make it not spray where you don't want it to spray. I'm gonna do, what's an easy quick symbol to make? I could do the anarchy symbol or maybe a smiley face. Let's do a smiley face. We'll do a circle here for one eye. Circle here for the other eye, and then we'll do a big smile. There we go. Nice, friendly, smiley face. Now, we could parent this light to that null, but I'm just gonna grab these position keyframes, copy, and go to the light's position, and hit paste. And then get rid of that null, just so we have a much cleaner little interface here. So we're almost there. All we need to do is tell Particular to use light emitter. And just like that, hey, we've got movement happening. Now, Michael, you'll say, that doesn't look like spray paint. And you're correct, but it will. First things first, we need to make the emitter size smaller, like one. And then actually, you know what? I'm gonna do the rest of this in the Particular designer. And a particularly nice thing about light emitters is that you get their animation in the designer, which is neat. So we don't want any velocity at all on our particles and no velocity from the emitter motion. And under the color, we will say, get it from the light emitter. So now we've got nice pink color there. We want the particles to be lasting longer. Our scene's 10 seconds long. So we can just say the life of these particles is 10 seconds. Want to bump up the particles per second some. Actually, I think I'm going to say instead of being continuous, be based on the emitter speed. That way when the emitter moves slower, the particles, you know, actually, no, that's not realistic. If you're going from a paint can, this amount of spray comes out, it's all the time anyway. So we'll leave this at 100 for now. We're going to bump up the size of these particles. Let's go to something like, let's see, 60. Is that good? That might be a little too big for this. Let's try 40. There we go, 40s looks pretty good to me. Let's make this particle a little bit more feathered here. Something like 80. So we have a little bit softer edge on there. And it looks like we don't need that many particles per second. Let's try 50. And on the size, we want some randomness as well. So it looks like the spray can is not quite as efficient as it might be. So let's put the size randomness up to like 30. So we get kind of a nice chunky, there we go. That adds some nice imperfection there. So there's the main core of our spray paint there. And one more thing on this environment here. If we turn the air density to zero, it shuts off. You see everything goes gray. It shuts off all this air environment stuff. So it's not having to run anything on that. So it saves a little bit of processing time. It looks like our smiley face is a little bit too chunky there. So I think I'll just make the size of the particles up a little bit. Fill that in, and maybe a few more particles per second. Let's go 55. That kind of fills that in. Okay, this part is okay because we're not going to have any particles showing for that bit. So let's name this system because we're going to have quite a few systems here and to make this effect happen. So we're going to call this one Core. I think naming your systems is a great way to keep yourself on top of things. And here we go. We'll add another system, and we'll just rename this one right away. This one is going to be our spatter emitter system. First of all, the emitter type is going to be a light emitter. And this one we can leave at a pretty large size because we want that spatter to be coming out. But we don't want those particles to be flying every which way. Again, we want them to be perfectly still. So we'll turn the velocity to zero and the velocity from emitter motion also to zero. Oh, and we need the life of these particles to be long as well. Same length as our comp, 10 seconds. And on this one, and for the color, let's pause it there. For the color, we could, again, go in here and say from light emitter, but we don't need to do that. We can just delete it. Anytime a block is empty, it will just take whatever the value was before. I think we do need a few more particles per second on this. So I'm going to crank them up to, say, 200. Feather on these down. Some of these are supposed to be pretty tight spatters. So we'll make the feather lower, but not all the way gone. Let's do something like 5. And let's make the particle size a little bit smaller too. It's just little tiny spatters. So we'll call that 3. And we'll take a size random all the way up. And there we go. We've got our spatter, which is looking pretty nice. Speckly spattery. We might want some more later, but yeah, let's add a few more particles per second to that. Let's try 300. Yeah, that's pretty good. I like that. All right. So next we want the paint that kind of drips down from this. So add a new system. We'll call this one drip lead. Put a little underscore in there. This is going to be our leading one there. And again, on this one, we're going to make it be a light emitter. But instead of spitting them out uniform, because the rest of these haven't had any motion, but this one we want some motion, so we'll say directional, which, as you see here, means it's pointing down. We don't want any velocity from the emitter motion there. And we do want this to be a smaller emitter. Let's make it probably about maybe 10. So it just spits down from our main system. That's working pretty good. We want a lot fewer particles per second. Let's go down to something like 1, maybe 2 for now while we're working on it. And I'm going to mess a little bit with the movement of these, but it's going to be hard to really see how it looks just with the leader ones there. So I'm going to get rid of this color so they'll stay pink. And let's make our fourth system here. We'll name this one Drip Trail. And this one, we will say you are going to emit from the parent. It's going every which way. We'll turn our velocity down to 0 and velocity from emitter motion also to 0. And instead of deleting this color chip here, let's just say color from parent 100%. Why not? That's looking nice. Oh, we need to make the life longer. 10 seconds again. So we got some nice strips going. Probably want them a little bit bigger. And these ones we can say, hey, you're going to be from parent speed, but I think we can probably have fewer, maybe like 50, maybe even less, 30. And we're going to make these size maybe a bit bigger. Actually, let's set the size of these to be inheriting the size from the parent with a little bit of randomness on it, perhaps. But we'll say inherit size from the parent particle. And let's deal with the parent particle size here. Let's say the size on this parent particle is maybe 10. 12, perhaps. Give it some randomness as well, maybe 20. And we'll say the size over life can be full, and then we'll slope down to like here, like that. So we get like a little bit of a blump, yep, that works. And actually, the way these are moving, these drops are moving down, I don't want them to have the same speed over their whole life. I want them to kind of come down, get a little faster as they kind of gain, as they kind of fall away and gravity starts pulling them, and then slow down and stop. So I'm going to go to the drip lead to the motion tab here, and I'm going to adjust this. It's the velocity over lifetime, which is very handy and very unused feature of Particular, I think. So we're going to start at around in the middle here. Go up to 100, and then we're gonna we'll just slowly ease down here, sloping down like that. See how that looks. Strips come out. That's pretty good. Let's make the life on these a little bit random as well. Maybe 100% randomness. So some of these drips are gonna be longer and larger. Some will be smaller and thinner because there's more paint per drip. Adding those imperfections to make it look good. Excellent. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. Now I want these paths to have a little bit of randomness to them as well. So let's get to where they're fully in the scene. And let's add some displacement to them. Just grab a default little chip block there. And we'll say turbulence field displace. Let's go, 30 or so. Let's not have any fade in on that. It'll just immediately start displacing. We'll make the scale a fractal a little bigger there. And we don't want that to be evolving because we don't want them to be wiggling. So evolution speed down to 0. So we should just have them kind of like a little bit of imperfection on their way, like this wind or bumps on the wall or what have you. Kind of make him just not quite perfect. Yeah, that's working out pretty good. So we'll hit apply. I believe we show systems. We go to our core here from lights. We're doing a particles per second modifier. We're modifying it by the light intensity. So on the light, we can just hit T and we'll say, hey, 100%, and we'll set that to be a right click toggle hold keyframe, and then we'll just say zero emitting there until we get over to where it's making the other eye, and right about there I think we'll say back to 100%. So we'll spit out particles there, and right there we're done. So back to 0, then we start making our smiley face somewhere around here, back to 100, until we're at the end of the smiley face, when we will go down to 0. So that should give us our little smiley face here. Let's have a look-see. Eye, and then smile. Well, that's great. We could probably take that smile and make it happen a little sooner.
We really don't even need these keyframes here in the middle. For a bit.
So we go eyeball, eyeball, and oh, that's too soon. I don't feel like the hand had time to get over there. Eyeball, and then there we go. Big smile. I think our spatter might be a bit too large, so we'll go back to our spatter in here and go to the emitter size, and we'll say emitter size be more like 300. We'll be a little tighter to our shapes. There we go. And I like it pretty good. So there you go. That's the technique for getting a good paint spatter. But remember, this is 3D. So if we hit to get a new camera in here, and then we kind of rotate it. Let's right click to the camera menu and hit create orbit null. That just gets us a null dead center and parents the camera to it automatically. It's very handy. R for rotate, and let's rotate this, 45 degrees here. You see, hey, we've got this is, three-dimensional spray paint. Gonna add a little bit of stylization to this with some roughen edges. And we're not gonna take it at the defaults. That makes it a little bit too blobby and loses all of our lovely spatter. We're going to take the edge type to spiky, give it a bit of some texture to it, and we'll make that scale significantly smaller. And also, not quite as sharp, maybe 0.1. And then we'll make the border significantly smaller as well, 0.1 as well. It makes those edge, maybe make the edge sharper, 10. You know what? It's up to you. That really gives it some nice crunch to the edge. One makes it a little softer, maybe 5. You know what? You tweak this, get it how you like it. But there we go. I'm going to go with that as my spray paint look. And of course, if I hit AA to get the light properties here, we could also animate the color. So if we wanted them to have, say, pink lips here, we'll have it be pink at the lip, and we'll have it be blue for the eyes, which would be kind of cool. And then we'll put that right there. So we got blue eye, and then pink for the mouth. In fact, let's make that change color over time on the mouth. Let's go from pink to yellow. You can do all kinds of great things. Oh, and if you want to stylize it, I've got Magic Bullet Looks on here. Over top of it, I've got just a little bit of optical diffusion, some heavy use of chromatic aberration, a bit of halation and renoiser with those settings there. And that gives it kind of this neat look here before and after. But, you know, you do you and go crazy. And then also, you don't have to just use this, you know, by itself. You could, if you wanted to get real fancy, put it in a scene. This is just using Red Giant Geo to make this wall. It's just a plane. And then under the materials, I'm using this color, let's say this color for bricks here. This is using the paint displaced. See, it's just a spray paint comp in here. And I'm using this ambient occlusion and this displacement map here to kind of make it see through a bit and to displace with some displacement map there to kind of make it go kind of in the brick holes there. So that's in this color for bricks comp, and I'm using that in Geo in the material section. Geo is great because you can have animated materials on your 3D models in After Effects. So I'm using the roughness map here and this normal map as a bump map down here, normal map right there, to really give it the texture, make it feel like it's part of the scene. And then I just copied and pasted the position of our light animation, scooched it in place for this can. And of course, Geo responds to After Effects light. So I've got this animated After Effects light here that's flickering. And the can kind of comes in and out of the light. So paint comes in and out of the light. It works great to just add, do whatever you want to with your spray paint. And yes, it's again, this is a 3D scene. So if I put it in a camera and made a little orbit null here, rotate. Let's orbit around here. Of course, we could use particular to put spray on there as well. Just really simply spraying out, hitting a flat wall there. Like, it's, there's all kinds of crazy things you can do with this technique. So I hope that was fun for you. Please play with this technique. Try your adding your own spin to it. And if you make something based on this tutorial, when you share it online, tag Red Giant on social media channels. Maxon, Red Giant on pretty much any of your favorite social media channels.